With dairy being such a hot topic of conversation and debate these days, you might be wondering, if you have a baby, how does this affect my newborn? Whether you're breastfeeding or giving formula or both, what exactly is cow's milk protein intolerance? Is it an allergy? Can I have dairy if I'm breastfeeding? Now, all those questions might sound like all the food fads out there is confusing what you're allowed or not allowed to have. But in fact, the effect of dairy or cow's milk on children is a well-documented scientific process. And I want to take you through all those questions and all those concepts. But for today's video here, we're going to dive into the actual molecular level difference between cow's milk and human milk. I'm going to look at how that difference is related to the symptoms that we see in what we call cow's milk protein intolerance. I'm a board-certified pediatrician and the founder of Kinder Digital Pediatric Clinic. On my channel here, I answer common questions from parents. I take you through the science and evidence behind what we do know, and also to engage in an open dialogue with you about medicine, health, nutrition, lifestyle, mental health, all the different things that influence children's health and development. So if you enjoyed these videos, let me know with a thumbs up below, consider subscribing to the channel, and let me know in the comments what topic you would like to see next. Be sure to hit that bell when you subscribe to get notified of new videos coming every 2 weeks to see if your question could be next. Now, if we think about all mammals, and humans count as one of the mammals, all the milk produced by mammals are made up of two important milk proteins. One is whey and one is casein. Now, even though they're made of the same two proteins, the ratio here is very different. And that is actually what makes all the difference when it comes to cow's milk versus human milk. I'm going to show you with my little science experiment set up here. I'm using oil to represent the casein and the white liquid to represent the whey. Now for people, when the baby's first born, early breast milk has about 80% whey and 20% casein. Now as the baby gets older, if mom is still breastfeeding, mature breast milk at this point has about 60% whey and 40% casein. So human milk will toggle back and forth somewhere between these two ratios. Now cow's milk, on the other hand, is a totally opposite ratio. We have 80% casein and 20% whey. All right, so why does this matter? Especially when I said both proteins exist in all mammals' milks and they're clearly both important for our nutrition. I don't want you to think of one is better, one is worse. They're not. But the ratio matters because our gut reacts quite differently to these two proteins in the process of digesting them. Now, whey is the lighter milk protein. It stays liquid through the gut throughout digestion, and it moves through relatively quickly. Now, casein is that heavier, bigger molecule. It's the part of milk that curdles on the bottom if you leave a cup out on the counter for too long. So it takes longer for the gut to digest casein as it moves through, which is much more slowly. Now, our human gut has evolved to handle the actual ratio of milk produced by humans. So in a healthy, balanced gut, things are moving forward. The intestines actually squeeze periodically to help move things forward and also are chemically breaking down everything moving through. We have the whey moving through first, and the casein, being slower, heavier, actually keeps us feeling full for longer. So the baby actually needs the casein to tide them over to the next meal. And the system works quite well with the ratio of proteins that we're used to. But what happens if we have too much casein? Now, the overload actually slows down the gut and in the process produces inflammation. So when the gut is trying to break down an excess load of casein, the inflammation and the slowdown are responsible for the symptoms we then see in cow's milk protein intolerance. Now, intolerance is not necessarily an allergy. And the difference here is quite technical. It has to do with whether our immune system has been activated to make antibodies. And we'll get to more on that in just a second. But first, if we look at intolerance, we talked about the slowdown and inflammation in the gut. Now, for a newborn or for young babies, what we might see are things like flecks of blood in the stool, diarrhea or mucousy stool, more gas. Also, sometimes just an increased fussiness, because I've seen babies with cow's milk protein intolerance where they just look yucky, like how you and I would look if we had a nausea or abdominal pain, because they can't quite tell us their symptoms. Now, to continue with this inflammation, it can actually go outside the gut and the intestines as well. So in babies, a common thing we can see with that is eczema. So that's where the skin gets rough and dry and thick, and they can flare up and be itchy, especially in quite young babies. having eczema early in life is commonly linked to calcium protein intolerance and the full body inflammation that can come. Now, to some people, this process actually involves the body, the immune system waking up, recognizing the overload of casein as foreign and actually makes antibodies called IgE. And that's when we cross into the territory of having an allergy to the calcium protein. Now, just from symptoms, it can be hard to tell whether it's just intolerance or allergy. But in general, those with allergy can have more severe symptoms, they have symptoms earlier, and also later in life, they're less likely to ever grow out of this reaction to dairy. Now, for our purposes, in either case, whether it's intolerance or allergy, chronic untreated reactions of inflammation can lead to problems with feeding, gaining weight, getting into failure to thrive territory. And like I said, sometimes babies just can feel crummy all over because they have and inflammation starting with their gut. So the severity of symptoms really varies, and some can be quite mild to pretty traumatic. So I encourage you to talk to your pediatrician if you have any concerns or you're wondering if your baby might be having this. And it really just comes from our system being a little different and having evolved to handle different milk than what's made by other animals. So I hope that makes sense in terms of why cow's milk protein allergy or intolerance is a thing and why, in my opinion, sometimes quite underdiagnosed, because the symptoms can be pretty mild and unspecific sometimes. Now in the next video, we'll talk about what you can do about this, whether you're breastfeeding or formula feeding or both. And later we'll also talk about milk for toddlers and later in life and how to think about how to find what's best for us and what are the options out there today. Thanks so much for checking out this video. This channel is all about bringing you the highest quality information about pediatric health in an open dialogue with practical advice. So until next time, stay well, and I'll see you in the comment section below.